First of all, this event where you are, I mean, right now I just see a curtain, but I'm assuming there's lots of stuff happening at the event. Who's there? What's going on? Tell us a little bit about it.
Yep. Well, first of all, thank you so much for having me on. I really appreciate it. And I enjoyed our conversation as well. It's just great to be here. We are at our fourth Delivering the Future event here. And there's a bunch of press that we have here. And we made a couple of big announcements in robotics today.
Can you tell us about them?
The first is in our manipulation robot that we call Blue Jay. And what Blue Jay, the way that you can think of that is that you can take three assembly lines and put it in the same footprint of one. What it does is help eliminate the menial, the mundane, and the repetitive. And it could pick more than 75% of the inventory that we actually sell in our sortable network, which is a really big deal. I'm really proud of that. And I'll also say there's just something interesting about Blue Jay as well as compared to our other bird manipulation systems, Cardinal, Sparrow, and Robin. It took us about 3 years to kind of design, deploy, and get out to our frontline employees. We have actually done Blue Jay with the power of AI in just over a year. So it's really had accelerated the pace of innovation.
I think what a lot of people think about Amazon and robots, I just want to jump in because we don't have a ton of time, but we'll get to some of the other announcements. They think about the Kiva Systems robots, the big acquisition at the time, 2012, that was a big acquisition for Amazon. And they've seen pictures of the way that those can move large loads of things across warehouses. But if you were to go into a state-of-the-art Amazon warehouse today, what would you see that's in addition to those Kiva robots?
Yeah, in addition to our the world's first goods-to-person fulfillment strategy, which was just a really good idea, where we have more than a million robots that we manufacture actually in Massachusetts doing that job every day, you're going to see more of the unstructured fields, right? So you're going to see green robot that we call Proteus that can move big cargoes of packages to the right dock at the right time. You're going to see many more manipulation systems that we have in there, eliminating kind of the repetitive motions that we have. No one wants to lift a 50-pound box all day. Robin does that. Cardinal does that, moving it into some of these Proteus-bound carts that we have. You're going to see much more collaborative robotics, right? So that's where we build our robotic systems to enable people to augment what people are capable of. And we really believe in the philosophy of people and machines working together. How can we build the tool set that enables our employees to do their job not only more efficiently, but also with better safety in mind?
All right. So there's this robot arm called Blue Jay. You just talked about it. You guys are using this AI agent called Iluna. And then you're also working with augmented reality glasses to be worn by drivers in delivery trucks in the field. There's like so much going on. Step back for a moment because you guys have a lot of data. You look at what you're doing. I'm just curious, investors who are thinking about Amazon and what you are doing, how do they think about the long-term like ROI, return on investment, when it comes to the investments you guys make in robots? Is the goal about labor efficiency, throughput speed, or is it margin expansion, kind of tie across your fulfillment operations? What is it?
Yeah, well, definitely efficiency. We think about efficiencies and how can we gain efficiency through all the chain of our fulfillment processes, for sure. And you mentioned data, and data is the fuel for AI systems. Data has allowed us to bring, think of the body of being our robotics, but bring the mind to robotics, allowing it to be more adaptable, more fluid. You can almost think of this as the ability to pour our robotic systems into any size building, any scale of building to amplify what our employees are already doing. We want to give them an amazing tool set. And we see that when we do that, we're more productive, right? When you do robotics right, when you do collaborative robotics, where you need both people and machines doing what they do best, and they do different things better, that it allows you to be more productive. And when you're more productive, that allows you to invest more in people. We've upskilled more than 700,000 of our employees, which is a great stat. And also in our robotics, we've expanded from the Kiva days, we've expanded from just a movement solution to now movement and mobility and sortation and storage and perception systems, packing systems that have really changed the game for our customers. That's a big deal to us.
But Ty, Well, you need less workers. And I got to bring it up. You know, the Times had a story out. They talked about interviews and a cache of internal strategy documents that they saw that it reveals that your execs think that the company's on the cusp of its next big workplace shift. I'm reading from the Times, and replacing more than 500,000 jobs with robots. So, you know, we know things change. I'm not in a horse and buggy anymore. I don't make things piecemeal. I get it. I don't get tons of faxes, and I don't get tons of pieces of physical mail. Thank God. Things change. Having said that, is Amazon, do you guys believe that you're on the cusp of a workplace shift and that you won't need as many workers because the advancements in robotics?
Well, there's no doubt that things change. I mean, and we're actually really proud of that in Amazon, is that we avoid stasis at all costs. We change and we adapt. And the nature of tasks definitely changes. And there's no doubt about that. We are laser focused on efficiencies inside of our buildings. But when it comes to that article was speculating 10 years out. Right, that's a 10-year speculation, and it's hard to say what's going to happen in the next 10 years. But I can tell you what happened in the last 10 years. The last 10 years, which is when we seriously invested in robotics, mm-hmm. that we created hundreds of thousands of new jobs and new job types. And there's been no employer in the United States that has employed more people than Amazon. In 10 years. I mean, that's the power of efficiencies and building your robots in a way that's applied and real, that actually augments the human potential.
All right. My brother Sam, I like a dog with a bone. So wait, so does that mean 10 years out, it could be less jobs, or we just don't know, or you don't think that's the case?
Well, you have to think about, I mean, there's jobs and there's tasks, right? So we, of course, we're changing the nature of tasks. Like, I'm very bullish on eliminating every menial, mundane, and repetitive job out there. Nobody wants to do that. So we're going to change those tasks 100%. But we can, again, as history has shown, we continue to create jobs, right? Mm. With the goal of two things. Can you have it all? Can you be more productive, which means more efficiency? And can you also create a safer environment for our employees? And we're actually doing both. That's what history has shown in the last 10 years. We have created better than 30% reduction in our overall recordable injury rate over the last 5 years because of our robotics, and also much more efficient. For example, our latest generation fulfillment center in Shreveport is 25% more efficient.